The Undertaker, joining us now live on your Home of America's Team with Shan and RJ. Good morning, man. How are you?
I'm doing good. How you guys doing this morning?
Doing well. Do I say Mark or Undertaker? What do you prefer?
Matt, it's whatever you prefer. It's, you know, most people at this point, they just abbreviate everything. Just call me Taker. That keeps everybody in the loop of who you're talking to, and you don't have to go through.
Why did they choose Taker and not Under?
I don't know. I'm kind of glad they did, but, you know, it's I don't know. I guess that's the natural abbreviation of Undertaker, I guess. I don't know.
What was the other name? What was the second choice or the one that you thought that besides Undertaker?
No, there was no there was no second choice. It was the original name was Kane the Undertaker, and then we eventually dropped the Kane, and it just became Undertaker, and that's it for the last 30 plus years.
So everyone was freaking out Sunday, seeing you hanging out with Michael Parsons. We know you were, out there for the salute to service with military members. Are you we know you were born in Texas. Are you a big time Cowboys fan? Are they your team?
Man, they lifelong. I mean, I was so excited to be there. It was the first Cowboys game that I've actually seen in AT&T Stadium. So yeah, I was having a blast. Cowboys have been my team. My gosh, I'm in my office at home. I've got a giant Roger Staubach jersey signed. I mean, wow. I've got all kind of Dallas paraphernalia. So yeah, Dallas has always been my team.
Roger, your number one favorite sports crush, favorite player, or someone else?
No, it's got to be Roger. I tell you what, Captain America, man. I can't tell you how many times in the backyard growing up, I was, I was stalled back trying to find Pearson in the back of the end zone somewhere. It was it was a good time.
All right,
and I actually saw him. I actually saw him Sunday too. So I had a little moment. So.
All right, who's the last person? Because everyone freaks out when you're around. Even on the Fox broadcast, they're like, "Oh, our kids only want us to get a picture with Taker." So the last time before Roger that you were nervous, who have you been nervous to go up to and meet or get a picture with?
You know what? Funny enough, I always kind of give. There's people that I'm fans of their music or whatnot. I really don't ever approach people. Unless it just happens by chance. I had one chance to meet, and I regret taking it. I had a chance to meet Muhammad Ali years ago, and he was within feet of me, but he was in kind of this closed area, and I had that moment like, should I or shouldn't I? Should I or shouldn't I? And I was like, no, he's not here for that. So I passed on it. But, I don't really usually get too starstruck. But, I always kind of put people – I always think, they think kind of the same way that I do. If they're, outside of the realm of what their profession is, you kind of just – okay, they're working. Let me leave them alone. Everybody's coming at them. Right. I'll just kind of – I'll take a pass, and that's one I kind of regret.
When did you realize the Undertaker, Mark Calaway, Taker, joining us here on Shan and RJ, when did you realize your fame, hit that level to where someone like Muhammad Ali may be aware of who you were, where you're going around and someone came up to you and you're like, whoa, they know who I am. When did that level really hit? Or was there a person where you're like, oh, my God, I'm a superstar?
It probably happened somewhere in the late 90s. But it's so strange because I was grinding so hard back then and putting in so many dates. I was really oblivious to everything. People ask me, what do you think about this going on or that going on? I'm like, I have no clue. I was so caught up. I was so caught up in our product. And, we were on the road back then. We were on the road close to 270 days a year. So I just wanted to know, where the hotel was, where my bed was, and what time I had to be at the arena. And, it was a grind, But I know by the 2000s, like, okay, you know, I kind of started to get that feel because, you know, people from all kind of different genres of entertainment, you know, were you know, like we'd see them backstage and they, you know, they'd be yelling at me from down the hall. You know, I'm like, wait a minute, man, that's Shaq.
Yes.
What's going on, you know?
That's and, awesome.
Yeah, so, you know, I've been very, very fortunate, and I've really actually have got to meet a lot of, you know, interesting people from different genres, and always just the nicest people they can be, especially, you know, on our, you know, in our arenas and our turf and everything. They've just, it's fun to see people that are superstars and that are legends be fans. I just you know, because you forget. Sometimes you forget that people are fans of different things. And yeah. Just to actually see that wholesome, honest being a fan, it's pretty cool.
He's the legend. He's the dead man. He's the Undertaker. Joining us right here on 105.3 The Fan. Obviously, you mentioned stadiums and seeing fans everywhere. Everyone's going to be in town next year. Two-night event, WrestleMania, coming back to the Metroplex. And you talked about stadiums. You also talked about your name earlier. You've wrestled at stadiums all across the world, including here in North Texas. Obviously, you're at WrestleMania 32 in a match. Also, back in the day when you wrestled at the Sportatorium under the name Texas Red. Of all the places you've gone to throughout the world, what are some of your favorite venues to perform at?
I tell you what. So when I wrestled at the Astrodome, being from Houston, I wrestled Triple H 1 year at the Astrodome. That was really cool. And then wrestling in, you know, AT&T Stadium, you know, that was just, you can tie all that together with my, you know, being a fan of the Cowboys. That was really special, and being able to break, you know, our, excuse me, our attendance record. You know, we put in, I want to say 101,000, people, you know, the last time that we were here. So those Wembley Stadium, that was, until that WrestleMania here in Dallas. I think Wembley Stadium was the largest crowd that I had performed in front of, which was 80 plus. You know, there's so many iconic venues that I've been to. The Garden, I mean, the Garden is just, you know, I mean, that's kind of the mecca of arenas. It was one of the places I always tell people, I said, I hated getting into it, but once you're in there, I mean, it's just, it's hallowed ground. And, you know, when your name's at the top of the marquee and you know that building sold out, that's a pretty special feeling.
You know, you do a lot of these interviews and a lot on sports stations, and you may not have people who are, you know, huge wrestling fans that are doing these interviews. So I've always wondered, what is the dumbest question you normally get when it comes to these interviews?
You know what? Boy, there is no limit to dumb questions, especially when it comes to people that don't follow us. I think the biggest one is like, hey, how do y'all make those chairs not hurt? I think I just look at people sometimes, you know, because there's been several. I know that I've had a couple of matches with Triple H where we have just beat the living hell out of each other, and you know, my back is just visibly scarred, bruised, and you know, bleeding, and then you get somebody like, how do y'all do that with the chairs, you know? And I'm like, yeah, well, basically we just knock the crap out of each other until somebody says uncle, and then, you know, but you know, it's funny, you know, people that aren't fans, you know, and they've always got to usually, you know, kind of give you that disclaimer. Well, we know it's not real, or you know.
Oh man, you know, there we go.
You know what I mean? It's like, okay, I think, are we not past that yet in 2021?
Yeah.
You know, I mean, it is. It's just silly, and it always just sets me off. In like, do you really feel like you need to say that because you don't want anybody to think that, hey, they're pulling the wool over my eyes. I'm telling you all about what's going on. You know, I've got 17 surgeries that say it's about as real as I need it to be. You know, but you know, it is what it is. And it's funny though, that when people like that aren't fans, if you can just get them to an event, especially a televised event or a pay-per-view, I would say 9 out of 9 times out of 10, they do have a much more of appreciation for what's going on, you know, what we do. But, yeah, there really is. The questions are it's limitless. Sometimes I'll be in an appearance or something, and I'll just have to stop and look up at somebody and, like, would you repeat that? Because I don't believe I just heard what you said.
Yeah. Well, you know, when you threw Mick Foley off the Hell in the Cell into a pile of marshmallows, you know, that was so comforting for him. The Undertaker joining us right here on 105.3 The Fan, getting ready for a two-night event, WrestleMania, next year here at AT&T Stadium. You mentioned other sports and going on Sports Station, and you're a big fan of other sports. Obviously, the Cowboys, you were at the game this past Sunday. And then you've also been a big fan of boxing, MMA. We've seen you at UFC events. Have you ever, ever in your career thought about stepping out of the ring and into the octagon?
Yeah, early on. Well, it was probably, oh my gosh, it had to have been 15 years ago, maybe probably more. You know, UFC was really coming on, and I've always liked tests. You know, I've always liked to test myself in one way or another. And I think if I had, I boxed a little coming up as a kid in my teens, my late teens, I did do a little boxing. But I think if I'd have had a wrestling, any kind of wrestling pedigree, that I might have just tried and dipped my toe in there. I mean, my love has always been for the WWE and what we do. I just thoroughly enjoy what we do, and but just this, you know, occasionally you just want to test the waters and see how you match up against people in different you know, genres of different sports. But that was probably the biggest reason why I didn't. And probably Vince would have had a coronary. He would have said, "You want to do what?" You know, he would have probably balked at the idea. But yeah, I think if I'd have had a stronger wrestling background, amateur, and when I say wrestling, I mean amateur wrestling background, I might have tested the waters. But
tell me, you played football. Did you at least play football in high school?
Yeah, I played football. I did everything, man. And I was that kid, like, everybody says, man, you need to go, you know, you need to go to college and play football. Well, I go to college and play basketball. I mean, I was just that kind of hard-headed. Nobody tells me what I need to do. I got to do it my way, or you know, it's not going to work. And I'm glad I did, because if I hadn't have gone the path that I would, it wouldn't have put me in the place where I decided that, you know, that I wanted to try wrestling. And once I got my foot in the wrestling door, I knew that was where my passion was. And I was blessed to you know, be able to find my passion. And so it all worked out for a reason.
Would you like to talk about the Longhorns?
Oh, man. I love my horns, man. I do. But good night. The honeymoon in Austin is over.
I have a feeling.
Already.
I thought you were back. We're back.
Yeah. You know how many times I've said that? So, at least ever since Mac left, I've said it 3 times. No, you know, honestly, I do think Sark is going to get them. I think they're going to get them on. Hang on, I got somebody's phone. There we go. I think Sark's going to get them lined up, but it's been hard to watch. I think, I don't even know if they're going to get bowl eligible this year. it's tough, because, you know, before the season starts, I talk a lot of crap about my horns, man. Always thinking, like, this is a bounce back year. There's no reason that the University of Texas should not win 10 games every year. Mm-hmm. I mean, it's just, they have more money than any program in the country. And, you know, it's, And now they're getting ready to go to the SEC. So,
yeah,
there you go.
You would not believe the amount of memes that I get on a daily basis that aren't too flattering of the horns and their trip to the SEC. But I think it's all going to work out. I'm you know what, I'm as loyal as they come. I when the Cowboys are down, I'm right there with them. And when my horns are down, I'm going to support them. And, but we're due, man. We're due. I think basically I just need to stay away. That's the biggest thing. I showed up at the Cowboy game Sunday and we saw what happened there. So I think if either I need to not watch the games or show up at the games, and they do a lot better.